Hello, welcome to all. Today we see the fifth chapter. Do you know very well? Our fourth chapter have theory. In fifth lesson onwards, we start Python with properly. Okay. Before that, in the last Friday, I give one form. It means Google form. One by test should be given. Assume that all of us attend this test properly. Okay. Now we see the fifth lesson. In this unit, the learning object are I take the lesson as two part. Part one, learning object are introduction, key features of Python, programming in Python, input and output function. Before I start this lesson, you set the laptop as Python software and do some exercise properly. Okay, I will be elaborately teach the lesson one by one. Be careful, listen the lesson, be carefully. If you see the PowerPoint properly, you do the work as your own. Okay. In the first year, we learn Dave C++ programming. In this year, we learn Python. Why Python in standard 12th curriculum? The reason is, the Python has been an important part of the Google. Do you know Google? What is Google? If you do internet, the Google is a main point. Do you know very well? Okay. The Python being popular is used by a number of tech giants like Google, Instagram, Pinterest, Yahoo, Display, IBM, Nokia. It means nowadays it's a very important one. So we learn Python in the second year. Why you use Python? Who use Python? Engineers, doctors, chartered accountant, and homemakers. It means it's a very simple software. So all of us learn Python, very simple. Okay. Now we go through the lesson. Who invent the Python? Inventor of Python. You see the picture. Inventor Gordio Van Rossum. His name is Institute name CWI Centrum Discord and Informative Netherlands is a place in the year 1991. You see this PowerPoint. Four questions, one word question been given. Who invented? They ask. Which institute? Which place? And then a year. Okay. Then next one. What is the key features of Python? In a general purpose programming language, it's a 3-mark question to you. 3 points should be given. It is a general purpose programming language which can be used for both scientific and non-scientific programming. What is scientific? If you learn physics, chemistry, it's a scientific. Non-scientific means commercial one. It is a platform independent programming language. Program independent language. Here we apply the interpreter. Then program independent language, very simple one. So the program written in the Python are easily readable and understand. Very simple. So this is the key features of Python. It's an important question to you. Then how to download Python? Use the now. You apply the Python version 3x. It's a free download software. Then the web address is www.python.org. If you go to the python.org, it's a free one. You download this Python software. Okay. Then in Python, two types of mode are used. What are they? First one, interactive mode programming. It means direct typing. It's a simple calculator. Simple calculator. The interactive mode computing, we simply show the icon like this. IDLG. IDLG means integrated development learning object. This environment is like this. I show the demo session later. Then how to start the IDL mode. If you have PC in the desktop, you see the start button. Start is another way. Start all program, Python 3x, IDL Python 3x is the another way to start the interact mode programming. Very simple one. Just you double click the IDL mode. Okay. The next one, interactive mode. The interactive mode, you see the, suppose if you apply the, you see the first one, interactive mode computing. You see the icon like this. You double click on it. Then the interactive mode screen is like this. If you refer the book, you see here also the menu bar, title bar, and then Python prompt is 3 > symbol at the same time. If you write 3 > symbol at the same time, it is we simply called as Python prompt. I already announced you, it's a simple calculator. If you go to the interactive mode, directly you type 5 + 10. Suppose if you give 5 + 10, the output will be 15. I show the demo session later. Okay, the next mode, you learn the first interactive mode. Second mode is script mode programming. Generally, in the Python, all the exercises can be performed in the script mode programming. What are the steps? A script is the text file containing the Python statement. If you learn Dave C++ programming properly, you do the file. The same process can be given in the script mode also. The script are editable. It's a properly we save the program. The step by step process is given below. First one, how to creating script in Python. If you see the screen, the menu will be file edit like this. In this option, you go to the choose the file, new file, or simple shortcut key is Ctrl N in Python shell mode. If you give the file new file, the screen show an untitled block script text editor will be displayed on the screen. If you give the file new file or simple shortcut key Ctrl N, the screen announce untitled. It means in this area you do the programming. Just you go through this, just I type the script editor. For example, a equal to 100. What is a? A is a variable. B is the constant. Here very simple. A value as 100. B value as 350. I simply sum the value. The output variable will be C. So I considered C equal to A plus B. Print is the output file. Okay. If you do the script editor, just whatever of the Python program, just you type it. A very simple code should be, I explain, it should be shown in the book also. And then after completing the code, file save. The file save or control R plus control S. It means the file should be properly saved. And then, do you know very well? Do you know the lab exists in the first year? The same process, if you save the file, the save as dialog box appear on the screen. Here you take the file location as Python. If you have the Python, or it should be created. And then here we give the file name as demo1. Here the demo is the file type, the file name I give. .py is an extension name, do you know very well? It should be not necessary. It means if you give the file name only, automatically it considers .py. The file type. Generally, the Python file program can be, the file extension name will be .py. Okay. And then, in the save as dialog box, you give the file name. Here, I give the file name as demo.py. Generally, you give the file name as your name or your exam number, and then your exercise number, whatever you need. Simply, in my example, I give the file name as demo.py. I type the demo only. Okay, no need to specify the file extension. Already you see, I told you in the last PPT, you see, once again you see, the file name will be what? Demo. Just I type the demo1. My file name is demo1. I type demo1. .py is not given, it automatically taken. Okay, it should be noted. No need to specify the file name. And then finally, click the save button to save your Python script. If you give the proper name, proper file name, it should be properly saved. And then how to execute the Python script? If you execute the Python script, you go to the run model, run with the run model, or simply you press the F5. So the output will be, what is the output? A value as 100, B value as 350, C equal to A plus B, print the sum, so the output will be 450. Okay, once again, it's a very important one to you. Once again, you go through the script mode programming. Your lab work will be based upon the script mode programming. You learn this step once again. First, what is the first step? Creating the script in Python. And then, second one, an untitled script texture appeared on the screen. Now, you type the Python code properly, you save, file save, or press Ctrl S. Save as dialog box appear. You give the proper file name as demo1 or your file name, proper file name. And then, executing step is, go to the run model. Or press F5. So based upon this step, we follow the Python programming. And the next step, what is debugging? If you have commit any mistake, it should be rectified. If your code has an error, it will be shown in the red color in the IDL window. Suppose if you commit mistake, it should be indicated as the red color in the IDL window. It should be corrected. And Python describes the type of the error occurred. What error? Suppose if you commit the spelling mistake or any error, it should be indicated with the proper red color. It's shown in the red color simply. So to correct the error, go back to script editor, make correction and save the file using Ctrl S or file save and execute again. Suppose if you commit mistake, very simple. If you commit mistake, it should be rectified to you. After rectification, proper file name should be given. So, the last step is file save or control S. For all error free code, the output will appear in the IDL window. Suppose if you rectify the errors, all the errors properly, it should show the output like this. Okay. Okay, then, input and output statement. What is input statement? The input function help to enter data at the runtime by the user. Suppose if we do the program, the input data you learn in the Dev C++ programming, the same process can be given. Input function. Input means you give some data based upon the program. The output function here, printf is used to display the result of the program on the screen after execution. In the Python, input statement is input function. The output statement is print function. We elaborately learned. What is input function? In Python, input function is used to accept data as input at runtime. The syntax for the input function is variable equal input prompt string. Suppose if you give the x value as 34, you should be right x equal int input enter 1. Here what is x? X is the variable. It should be 34 is the integer type, so we give the int. And then input is the key value. The prompt string is based upon the program, it should be changed. Here, I consider two number, first number as enter 1. Here, the prompt string is enter number 1. The same process as the y variable also. I considered y value as 56. So, once again, y is the variable name. 56 is the integer we specify as int, the keyword input, a prompt string will be the second number, so we give the enter number 2. And then just we print it, we print the value, print is the what, print is the output statement, the sum equal in the double quote is the prompt string, x plus y is the calculation, so just you type the coding in the Python code properly, You save the program and then after completing, it asks the input value, enter number 1. We give 34. Second number as 56. And then the result will be 90. Okay. Then what is print function? In Python, the print function is used to display result on the screen. So the syntax for the print is as follows. If you see the result, we apply the print statement. Very simple. I give the one example as intact Python code. It's a simple calculator. I already announced to you. X equal to 5. What is x? X is the variable, 5 is the constant. Y equal 6. I give the two value as 5, 6. X as 5, y as 6. I calculate the sum. I find the sum z equal to x plus y. Print z. Very simple. So, it add 5 plus 6. The output will be 11. Okay. Here now, I give the live demo. Just watch. How do I give the live demo? It is important to you. Okay. If you apply the Python, the Python window is like this. What is this? It is the, I already explained to you two mode. What are they? First one, interactive mode. Here I show the interactive mode. One example to you. How to take an interactive mode? If you properly apply the software program, the interact mode application will be, it means the shortcut icon of the interact mode application will be like this, Python 3.7.32 bit. Just you double click on this application. Okay, the screen show like this. For example, I give one example. It's a simple calculator to you. Just I type first value as 5 and then plus symbol, second value as 10. If you give the enter, the answer will be 15. It's a simple example to you. It's an interactive mode programming. Okay. Another example. Suppose if you give 8, first value, second value as 12. Just you press enter. What is the answer? 8 plus 12, the answer will be 20. Very simple one. It's a simple calculated mode. It's an interactive programming. Okay. I close this mode. The close this application. Just close. Apply the close button. Okay. The next one. Next mode. IDLE mode. If you take IDLE mode. If you double click the IDLE Python coding. IDLE. In this mode. The editor will be file, the menu, file, edit, cell, debug, option, window, help. Suppose if you do the program in this mode, once again I repeat, suppose if you give the, first you learn interactive programming mode, next we learn the script mode. If you take the script mode, just you go through the IDL icon, double click on the IDL icon. If you double click on the IDL icon, the Python 3.7.2 cell, the menu will be shown. So, here, if you do the program, first you click the file and then go to the file new, first command. Okay. I give an example based upon your book. If you refer your book, page number 50 in your new book, A equal 100. Just I type A equal 100. And then B value as 350. B equal 350. And then C equal add the two. A variable and a B variable. And then print. I type print. Print. Bracket open, double quotation open, the sum. Just I type it. You practice. in your lab. Now in your laptop. Okay. Before this, you save the file. Once again, go through. If you commit any mistake, it should be before saving. You, my kind advice is, once again go to the program and then check the all the statement is properly you type. Okay. What is the next step? You save the program. Here we apply file. Very simple. Save as file, save as. If you apply file, save as, here first time you go to the Python folder. Okay, you select the Python folder and then you give the file name. Our file name will be, for example, DEMO. I already given, so I simply give the file name as my name, Prabhu1.py. Here .py is not necessary. You simply give the Prabhu also. Very simple. It's a first practice. You give the file name and then your extension will name, the name will be .py, and then save. Before you see, the proper file name should be given. The screen show the untitled. If you give the proper name, what is the proper file name? My file name is given. You do your name, Prabhu1. So I click the save button. I click the save button here. The file should be saved. You see, Prabhu1.python. Okay. Then what is the next step? You see the result. How you move the run option. Run model file. You see the result. The sum equal to 450. Okay. This is the demo to you. Okay. Now you go through the lesson. I give some exercise also. For interactive, just you practice interactive mode programming. You type the code 1. You type the programming. It should be given in your book also. Code 1. You type the programming in interactive mode. Find the answer. Code 2. Find the answer. Code 3. Find the answer. Code 4. Find the answer. Code 5. Find the answer. Code 6. Find the answer. Code 7. Find the answer. Code 8. Find the answer. Okay. Okay. Once again, I repeat to you, this is an important lesson to you. In this lesson onwards, you load the Python software and do the exercise properly. Okay, thank you.